Thank you for coming to the Leader Chat for December of 2019. Today's topic is about creating a girl boss. So we're talking about financial literacy. Tonight, we are going to cover the 5 skills that girls should learn about when they're learning about financial literacy. We're going to learn about the badges and pins that are available for girls to earn. We're going to learn about the leader's role in the cookie program and the fall product program, but mainly touching on the cookie program coming up and the safety aspect of financial literacy and learning these skills. So first, what are the 5 skills? So the 5 skills are goal setting, decision making, money management, people skills, and business ethics. So these skills are written right on the side of the cookie box. So our customers are able to see that as well. But these are the 5 skills that we want our girls to learn while they are participating in our cookie program and our fall product program. These skills matter because when your Girl Scout has learned these skills, she'll be poised for success in her career. If you think about it, when employers interview job candidates, they all look for the same things. And this is true whether the employer is a bank, a high-tech company, a university, hospital, a publishing house, a car dealership, an accounting firm, or even the local pet store. So employers typically want someone who can set goals and meet deadlines, because blowing a deadline can mean blowing a deal. They want someone who works well with others, because who wants to deal with strife and complaining in the workplace? Definitely not the boss. They want someone who understands customers, and it doesn't matter whether the customers are hospital patients, TV viewers, or other companies. Every business has its customers and what they want. They want someone who can influence others. This doesn't just mean selling a product. Employers want people who can sell ideas, pitch products, and make deals. They also want someone who's honest, trustworthy, and reliable, and this goes without saying, or at least it should. And they sound like anyone, or does this sound like anyone you know? That's your Girl Scout, using the 5 skills she learned in the cookie program. So let's dive a little deeper into each of the skills and see kind of what they look like in action. So first, we're talking about goal setting. So goal setting may look like your Girl Scout not telling you on a Sunday night that her science fair project is due on Monday, the next day. She would instead be able to plan further out and have time to complete the project in multiple steps. This also may look like when your Girl Scout goes to apply for college or apply for scholarships, she'll be ready to create a well thought out plan for her research in applying for these scholarships. So think about what important goals you want your Girl Scouts to set for themselves now during their Girl Scout year, and in the future, what you want long-term for them. This is where we're trying to get at during these programs. So the second skill that we'll dive into is decision-making. So part of decision-making in this instance is gonna be how to spend money. So let's say your Girl Scout starts babysitting. She's gonna have her babysitting money. So part of what we want girls to learn is to make decisions on how to spend that money. So maybe they're gonna spend it, maybe they're gonna save some, and maybe they're gonna donate some. We want them to be able to use their money the way they have decided to use their money. We also want them to learn to give back to their community. So as she grows up, she'll know when and how to give back to her community. Those are decisions she'll be able to make. So think about when you're teaching this skill, think about what important decisions you want your Girl Scouts to be prepared to make now and in the future. The third skill we'll dive into is money management. So your Girl Scout will learn how to manage the money, so she'll be less likely to lose money. For instance, if she's supposed to take money to school for a field trip or her lunch money, she's less likely to lose it from the house to the school if she's taught some money management skills. She's also going to be more prepared to have conversations about handling a checking account or helping with grocery shopping. So think about what important things you want your Girl Scouts to learn about earning and managing money. The fourth skill is people skills. So she'll be able to ask other people for help when she needs help, and not when she doesn't. And she'll be able to work well with others on a team or working well with others, for instance, customers that she may be talking with. So think about how you want your Girl Scouts to influence others when you're trying to teach this skill. And the last one is business ethics. So if she has business ethics, this will look like friends, classmates, and teachers finding her to be trustworthy. And she will, throughout her life, develop excellent references. So job references, college references, whatever she may need a reference for, people will find her trustworthy and want to give her one. So think about what you want your Girl Scouts to be honest with you about or honest with other people about. So overall, the girls are going to learn the importance of earning money to support themselves. They're going to bring the values of honesty and responsibility to their chosen careers. They'll have the skills to run their own business and even persuade investors to back them. And they'll be able to influence others in their work and their community. So now we'll dive into the different badges and pins that are available for girls to earn. So you can see here, this is the cookie pin. We have had a cookie pin in the past, but this year they've changed it a little bit and they have made it a cookie entrepreneur family pin. So this is really an award that the whole family works on with their Girl Scout, so that the parents can get sort of a hands-on or have a hands-on approach to helping their daughter learn these financial literacy skills, which is very important for the cookie program. The selling cookies isn't just about selling cookies and making money for the Girl Scouts or their troop. This is really about the girls being able to learn these skills. So this pin and earning this pin will help those girls earn the skills, and it will help the families or the parents, the guardians, whoever is working with the girl, be able to better understand what the girl's supposed to learn out of this. So I have the example for first year Daisy or for Daisy's here. Maybe. So this is just one example. So the Daisies will do this. So the first time they do this, so as kindergartners, they would earn this pin here. The second time they do it as first graders, they'd earn this pin. So really they work with their family member to set a goal. So they're gonna set a goal to as how many packages they want to sell. And that will depend on what they want to do at the end. So if a girl wants to go to camp, she knows that camp costs X amount of money. Maybe their parents have said, oh, I'll pay for half of it. So she knows she has to earn X amount of money. So then she can see how many boxes she'd have to sell to earn that amount of cookie dough to be able to go to camp. You can see here also there are light bulbs around. That is for the parents to give them an idea as to how to guide the conversation. So if a girl says, I'm going to sell 2,500 boxes of cookies, then the parent knows that might not be a realistic goal, they can work with the girl to help set a more realistic goal. It's not that everybody has to achieve their goals, but we want to make it so the girls can as much as possible. So then the girl would decide how she was going to reach her goals. Is she going to go door to door? Is she going to set up multiple cookie booths? Is she going to call all of her friends and family? How is she going to do that? So the tip here is to work it. So if she wants to sell to coworkers, don't just have the mom send the or dad or guardian, whoever, send the order form around work. She needs to come in and talk to the coworkers and pitch them in person. Or if she can't be there in person, have her draw a poster, make a video that she can share with them, or send them a link to her digital cookie platform, something to get the girl involved. Then we want her to practice with money. So this will help her learn to count back the money to any customers that may give her some. We want her to learn to talk to customers. So this is really role-playing and having someone pretend to be a customer and her trying to sell them and talk through that. And it's okay to be tough during these conversations because she's going to get a no at some point. Not everybody's going to want to buy cookies. And so by doing this role play, the family member can help her learn how to navigate what she should say when she gets a no. And finally, we want her to think like a Girl Scout. So this is the business ethics part. We want her to be able to meet deadlines. So if the leader has a due date of when money should be back in, we want to make sure that the money gets back in. We want her to make sure that she's starting the sale on the official start date or after and not before. So the parent should help her prepare to lead. So for more business ethics basics, take another look at the Girl Scout law, from reminding your girl to be honest and fair to telling her to use resources wisely. It's full of cookie boss wisdom. So really just taking it back to the Girl Scout law and reinforcing that piece. So that is the cookie pin there. Once that's complete, she would just turn that into her leader. And then depending on how the troop runs, the leader can buy all of the cookie pins, or the parents can come in and just get the cookie pin out of the boutique. So as you can see, there's one pin for each grade level. All right, so the other financial literacy badges are here. So this is, these are all of the badges for each grade level. You can find the curriculum for these either in the Girl's Guide to Girl Scouting, or you can find them on the volunteer toolkit. So while these badges here are all of them for financial literacy, you can see that there are four for Daisies, four for Brownies. That's one for the fall product program and one for the cookie program each year. So as kindergartners, they'll earn two of the leaves, and as first graders, they'll earn two of the leaves, and so on and so forth. Then this next slide will show you the ones that are geared more toward the cookie program. So this Daisy Count It Up badge and the Daisy Talk It Up badges, those are geared toward cookies versus the money counts and the making choices. Those are geared more towards the fall product. So then this slide shows you what girls will learn during each of the financial literacy badges and then what that means. So for instance, this Brownie Meet My Customers, they'll learn how to talk to customers, count change, and role play for better customer relations. And that means that they will be developing a sales pitch and being able to deliver it confidently, and that will empower the young girls. and gives them tools to benefit in other areas of their lives, from running for student council to convincing their soccer team to practice more. So you can see that each of these, they'll learn things that are directly related to the cookie sale, but then how that applies in their everyday life. You can find this information on GSUSA's website if you want to read more in detail. You can also follow up this webinar. I'll email it out and you can pause it on this to be able to read through it. So this is just the second group of ages and their financial literacy badges for the cookie program. So what is the leader's role in this financial literacy part of the cookie program? So really, we want you to be a coach to your Girl Scouts. So listen to her practice her sales pitch, review the cookie materials together, and visit the Girl Scout cookie and cookie company websites with her to learn more about her product. So there are probably going to be questions about allergens. So people who can't have peanuts, people who can't have dairy, people who can't have different things. So on the cookie company's website, they have that information out there. They have the allergens out there. So helping her learn more about that product that she's selling, so she's able to answer those questions when they come up, or any other questions that might be asked. So ask her questions, pretend to be a potential customer and help her learn those answers. Guide her to set practical and useful goals about what she wants to learn and earn. So again, like the parents are doing for the pins, the leader can also coach the girls to those goals. Maybe there's a troop goal that all of the girls are working toward, and you can encourage each of the girls to play a role in that. Be a role model for business ethics and safety, and have fun. So the other piece is we want to encourage the parents to also coach their Girl Scouts. So one way is through having them earn the Cookie Entrepreneur Family Pin, but there are also some other ways. So for instance, if a girl says, "Hi mom, here are the cookie order forms. Can you just write a check like you did last year?" We don't want the parent to just say, "Okay," but we want them to have a conversation with the girl. So say, "You know, I heard the cookie sale is a lot of fun. What's your sales pitch? Let's make a list of people you can sell to. What else can you say or do to help your Girl Scout learn to sell?" Those are the type of things that we want them to think about, what they can say and do to help them learn. So if a Girl Scout comes to the parents and they say, "I don't want to go to the cookie booth tomorrow," we don't want them to just say, "Okay." We want them to ask questions as to why they don't want to go to the cookie sale, because they had made a commitment to going. So we want them to talk through that. It remind them that it's part of their goals, but also talk to them. Maybe they're just nervous because they don't know what to say. So then the parent can practice with the girl. What they say to their customers, or ask them what they will say to their customers when they ask them to name their favorite cookie. So just different conversations to work through why the girl doesn't want to go versus just saying, "Okay, we don't have to go." One thing that the girl may say is, "Here's that order form. Will you collect orders for me at your office?" We don't want them to say, "Okay." We want them to say, "Let's make a poster that tells people about your group's goals." And then they can deliver the cookies personally when they get the orders in. So for parents, we also want them to go to the family cookie meeting that the troop has. We want them to sign and return all permission slips. We want them to provide transportation for order taking and delivery of cookies for their girl. We want them to help your Girl Scout network with family and friends, but let her do the asks so she can learn the important business skills. So they can do a warm introduction for the girl, but then the girl should really be the one asking for that sale. They should help her arrange to take orders at the workplace, place of worship, or other places where people might purchase Girl Scout cookies. They should offer to be a supervising adult. There are lots of opportunities to lend a hand. That means that at cookie booths, it doesn't necessarily have to be the troop leader there every time, but it can be another supervising adult as long as they've completed all the requirements. They should also share their business expertise. Maybe they know a lot about sales and they can share that wisdom with their Girl Scout. They should follow the Girl Scout Council and group guidelines on how to handle cookie proceeds. So they should make sure that all of the cookie money gets turned into the troop on time. And they should never do things for their Girl Scout that she can do for herself. We're really encouraging girls to learn and grow. And by doing everything for the Girl Scout, she's not going to do that. So remember that the Girl Scout cookie program is part of the Girl Scout leadership experience, which is girl-driven. We need to let the Girl Scout take the lead in selling cookies and reaching goals. Your encouragement, coaching, and guidance will be key ingredients to successful cookie program experience for her. So then we have some tips for a fun and safe program. So for cookie booths, this is also from GSUSA. So cookie booth essentials are a good place for leveraging cookie smarts and unleashing the entrepreneurial spirit. So it tells about booth requirements and different tips there. But then it also talks about tips for safeguarding cookie money. So after receiving cash and change, the girl should hand the money to a volunteer for safekeeping and deposit into the cash box as soon as possible. Keep the cash box in a safe place or behind a barrier of cookie boxes. Don't walk around with large amounts of money. Bank cookie money often and do not keep money at home or at school. So as soon as that money gets in, it should go into the bank. Reduce cash transactions by offering credit card payment options whenever possible. So you can do that through the digital cookie app. There are different what-if scenarios down here to coach your girls through. So what if you're approached by an irate customer? Try to get a good look at the person in case you need to describe them. If the situation calls for it, call 911 and alert security. But don't argue with them or negatively engage with a customer. Try to stay calm. So there are different scenarios here that it can help you walk through what the girls may or may not encounter. So again, this is on GSUSA's website under the cookie booth information. So there is also that digital aspect to our cookie program in digital marketing. So there is an internet safety pledge or a digital marketing pledge at gsusa.org. That's something you can go over with the girls just to ensure that they're going to stay safe. So for instance, they should think about how the digital marketing will help with their cookie sales because we know that it does. But we want to make sure that they're still honest, they create a sense of urgency, they make an impression, they highlight special features or products, and they use clear and prominent call to action. but we also want to make sure that their marketing materials don't reveal their personal contact information, like your address, school, or last name, or the exact cookie booth location for that girl. Another safety tip on here is to protect your personal identity. Never directly message people you don't know online or through social platforms, and remember to always use your secure sales link for orders. We want to make sure that when creating marketing content or materials, to remember to get permission to use any images, songs, content, or ideas that come from someone else. When in doubt, create your own. So it gives you different tips for digital marketing, but also those safety tips there. And the last one's just general safety information. It's coming. Go. So the different safety tips for product sales. So you want to show that you're a Girl Scout, wear a membership pin, the uniform, Girl Scout clothing, etc. Use a buddy system, always go with someone else. Be familiar with the area that you're going to. Partner with adults, plan ahead. Don't enter a home or a vehicle, always stay outside. Sell during the daytime, protect the girl's privacy, being safe on the road, and follow safe pedestrian practices, and then be net wise, which goes back to that digital marketing piece we just talked about. So those are different tips on how girls can stay safe during the program. So again, those are on GSUSA's website. I will link to all of this stuff in the follow-up email once this webinar gets loaded onto our website. All right, does anybody have any questions? I can take questions now, but if you have questions after we get off this call, or you're watching this recorded and have questions, you can email customercare@girlscouts-gsci.org or call our 800 number at 888-623-1237. So I'll open it up for any questions now. All right, I don't see any, so I will let everyone go for the night. Thank you for joining me, and have a great day.